This is a great room. I bet you guys spend a lot of time in here.
Yeah, we spend a lot of time in here between Nathan playing and us watching TV.
Yep.
Yeah, the only thing that's frustrating, Tommy, is we feel very disconnected from the kitchen when we're in this space. It'd be nice to try to open that up a little bit.
Open it up? You mean like put a hole in this wall over here?
That would be perfect.
All right. Well, I think we could do that. But first I have to look and see what kind of wall this is. All right, I checked down to the basement and I know what kind of wall you have here.
Okay.
Now there are actually two different types of walls. And let me show you with this board game right here. Now if I take this piece right here, I can remove it and nothing happens. That's a partition wall. And that does nothing but divide the space up.
Okay.
You can cut a hole in it, you can remove it without any problem.
Perfect.
Sounds
but
easy.
There's another type of wall right here. Now this would be a load-bearing wall. I have to worry about all this weight up above and where is it going to go? It's going to come down. So I have to worry about the floor up above or maybe even some of the roof coming in on us if you cut into a load-bearing wall and you don't know what you're doing.
Okay.
All right. What you have is a load-bearing wall.
Seriously?
Seriously.
So does that mean we can't put a hole in the wall?
No, no. We can cut into it, but we have to know how to redistribute that load above.
Okay.
All right, now inside the walls, there's structure, studs. In this case, 2x4s that not only define the wall, but are also carrying the weight of the floor above. The studs are set 16 inches on center, but those studs are in the way of the new opening. But I can't just remove those studs because the load above won't be supported. By installing a header across the opening, it gives the load a path. That load will be spread across the header and will be carried by two new studs on either side of the opening called jack studs. The same style framing is used for door openings, windows, or even a simple pass-through like this. Now the next thing I look for is any ductwork, water lines, or electrical in the wall. You don't have any ductwork, you don't have any water lines, but we do have electrical. So the electrician is on his way to take care of that, but we can still get started.
Great.
All right, now before we cut a hole in the wall, I have to temporarily support this floor above and take the load off of this wall. To do that, I'm going to put this plate up against the ceiling. I have another one on the floor. And you guys take a 2x4 and push them in between there. All right, so let me have it right over here. All right, now put the bottom in. Push it right about there. Okay, now we're going to pull the top over towards you, nice and tight. All right, you too, to get it tight. Okay, don't make them, you don't, just want to make them nice and snug. Now we're going to cut the wall with a reciprocating saw. I want you to stay close with the vacuum to keep the dust down. All right, let's get this wallboard out of here. Now we can cut out the stud. We've located the hole in the wall where you want it, but what I want is a stud in the wall to end my header to. But I don't have a stud until it's way back here. So what I've done is I've pieced in some 2x4s to bring that closer to my opening. I'm going to put my last piece in right now, but before I put it in, I've attached this small piece of 2x4 so when it goes in the wall, it'll be at this height right here so the plate will rest on it.
Perfect.
All right, now we're ready to put the sill plate in. Slide it into the opening. All right, Zach, wanna pass me that second sill plate? All right, this is your new header, and it's actually two 2x12s that I cut to length, ripped down a piece of half-inch plywood, and sandwiched that between the two 2x12s. The reason I sandwiched the plywood in between the header is because the two 2x12s together are only 3 inches. A 2x4 is 3.5 inches. So the half inch plywood actually makes up that extra width that I need. And it also stiffens the beam. So I glued it and screwed it, and it's nice and strong. Now we're ready to put it in place. I'll put my end in first. I have to go up high, you stay down low. Okay. Okay, now let me slide one of my jacks in there. Okay, good. Tighten it up just a little. You all right?
Yeah.
All right, Zach, you want to push it up? Vicky, you want to grab that jack and put it under there? Put it in on an angle. Beautiful. Okay, now we can just hammer those in and the beam will go up. With the header in place, we can remove the temporary wall. All right, you ready?
Oh, wow, that's awesome.
It's only halfway.
Yeah.
There you go. All right, now the doorway here has an arch in it, so I replicated that around the new opening into the kitchen. Now all I have to do is finish off the inside with a little bit of plaster work and around the inside of the perimeter of the arch, and it's all done.
This is perfect, Tommy. Thank you.